train is a 3-minute ride.
Don't get me started on that train.
I hate the train.
I hate that train.
If you're in high heels and you're a slut, ride the train. Anyway,
right.
What else is there, Rena?
So there's a photo out today that most people have probably seen, everybody's talking about, of Osama bin Laden sitting on the floor in some dumpy-looking apartment watching videos of himself.
Hey, has anyone else been sitting back going, that's $1 million compound?
That's what I keep saying. I'm like, what is he doing? Didn't he not leave the compound for like 5 years?
He should have. He should have checked Zillow.com to see what things are selling for in the neighborhood.
Ghetto. I mean, do they not have an IKEA in Pakistan?
Yeah, I have
Did you see that furniture? Ugh.
No idea.
Ugh.
And who would pay $1 to see what it used
Who would
to be?
Think that a little 13-inch television that looked to be a black and white, I don't think those really come with remote controls.
$1 million, you maybe think you'd get a flat screen?
He didn't need a remote. He's sitting like 2 feet away, and his mother should tell him that he's going to go blind sitting that close to the TV.
Great point.
Hope he was eating some carrots. You can't see them in the picture.
All right, so what happened in this video?
You know, everybody, or there's always somebody who takes some little nugget of news and they can spin it into America's largest entertainment while you're supposed to be working in a matter of 10 minutes. So there's a website, and I just posted it on our blog, mynorthwest.com. Go to the Ron Don Show page. It's timscott.com/Obama. So basically, you see this picture of Obama sitting next to the little TV screen.
Awesome.
Oh, no! I did it! I Fox News!
Everyone,
I can't believe it!
Everyone.
Have you guys done it?
Yeah.
It's really hard to do.
I did it, but I dumped myself, so it didn't go out.
Oh, you did?
Yep.
Why didn't anyone dump me?
Everybody did.
Okay.
So Osama.
Basically, if you go to this website, you can enter in any YouTube web address that you want, and it will replace that little TV with any YouTube video that you want. So, you know, Osama watching Justin Bieber. Hours of laughter. Osama watching a little girl reading a book about
Maybe
kittens.
Kittens.
Ha, 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 ha.
That's very
Osama
funny.
Watching your son in his first grade play. Priceless.
I think we can keep going, but why should
I'm watching Osama watch the WWE right now. No, and then, he is watching Justin Bieber.
I want to put in myself in there. That would be fun.
Yeah.
You
can do whatever you want. As long as it's on YouTube.
And then I want to write a book about it called Osama and Me.
Yeah, there you go. And if you haven't seen these pictures, you don't know what we're talking about. They've been in the news cycle since this weekend, and they had a press conference over the weekend, and they released a bunch of these photos, and those are also up on the website. So what else is ringing your bell today?
Yeah. This story really surprised me, actually. So there's a 23-year-old NYU student, and he's the one who's responsible for all of those silly Osama's Dead t-shirts.
He had a lot of them.
It was osamadeadtees.com, so popular ones like Obama Kills Osama and Just Dead It, which I don't really think are particularly exciting t-shirts. But anyway, this guy made $100,000 in 2 days just selling these t-shirts.
It's a lot of t-shirts.
It is. And now
feature dead people, and we all wear them all the time. Jimi Hendrix t-shirts are obviously...
He wasn't killed.
Was he murdered or assassinated?
We don't know.
Or assassinated or killed in action?
There could have been someone in there. No, I'm just saying, dead people on t-shirts is a whole industry.
So it must be right.
No, I'm just saying, don't get fixated on this one dead t-shirt.
Just because...
This guy should have kept the money in there.
Just because you have a Dexter t-shirt.
He was there first. He made $100,000. It's stupid to give the money back. That must be...
Do you guys remember after the Gulf War? This was my big memory of the Gulf War, because I was like in middle school. The Saddam Hussein t-shirts. Saddam Hussein. Oh, wait. Saddam Hussein.
Right.
Remember that? That
it's
was
a great
sick.
T-shirt.
That was
funny.
College parties
everywhere. Yeah. What's our final story?
Is the most spoiled, and their parents have so much money in general that they don't really have to have.
That's what I'm saying. Like, I get tired.
Say that's all the parents that just got foreclosed on,
right,
and don't have a job, and their 401k.
You bring a kid out to the farm. Hey, dig these fence posts.
No way.
It's like grab the post pole digger and dig.